Good afternoon, I am Amrit Ghosh and the subject on which I am giving my speech, that means I want to deliver the speech, is Introduction to Signals and Systems, EC360. This is for CSE, Computer Science and Engineering, 5th semester. So, mainly in Introduction to Signals and Systems, whatever we will deal with, first it will come like this, that what is signal, what is a system, and after that there are the classifications of signals along with their definitions and examples and mathematical expressions, classification of system along with their definition and mathematical examples. After that, what will come? How we can represent different type of signals, how we can represent different type of systems. Of course, if there will be any such mathematical structural equation like differential equation, difference equation, there will be state space variable, including state space variable, the state space equation, like that. After that, Fourier series and Fourier transform will be coming over there, followed by Laplace transform, and we have to see how we can incorporate all the properties like adding, shifting, convolution, scaling, etc. with the help of Fourier series, Fourier transform, Laplace transform, and of course after that Z transform will come. The important thing which I should tell you over here, that here also we will see how we can derive a particular formula, whatever we will write in Fourier series or in Fourier transform or in Laplace transform or in Z transform. What will be their application? The region of convergence will be coming, and after that we will go to random variables, statistical interpretation, random signals, etc. So in a nutshell, this is the whole thing that I told you. Now coming to the first thing, that what is a signal? What is a signal? Signal, it can be of various nature. That means it is a type of thing that should be given to a system, or you can say it could be given to an entity to get a desired output. That means whenever it is fed to an entity or to a mass or to a particular thing, it will be treated as an input signal. And whenever we will get the output, the desired output, irrespective of any parameter, that will be the output signal. So in a nutshell, signal can be treated in terms of input as well as in terms of output. Is it clear? So signal can be given as input signal, signal can be given as output signal. Now the important thing, where the signal will be given, what is that mass or what is that entity that will conjugate with the signal to produce the output from a particular input, irrespective of any parameter, that is nothing but the system. That means signal and system, they are very much closely related with one another. Now, for this signal and system, the most important thing is time. The alphabet that we use for the notation of time is T. It can be expressed either in S or set or seconds. Or by seconds. Clear? So we can represent the unit of time by this various notation, either this or this or this. Okay. Why time is so important? Because with respect to time, we can determine the signal. It may be possible also that with respect to time, we may not determine the signal also. So depending on that, there are mainly two types of signal. One that is known as deterministic. One that is known as deterministic signal. Another one that is known as non-deterministic signal. What is a deterministic signal? A deterministic signal is such a signal which can be measured with respect to time. If we can measure that signal with respect to time, that will be a deterministic signal. It may be a voltage signal, it may be a current signal, it may be a power signal, it may be any acoustic signal, any sound signal, etc. But if that particular signal, if that particular thing we cannot measure with respect to time, then it is known as non-deterministic signal. You will be wondered how non-deterministic signal will be there, because every signal can be determined with respect to time. Okay. There is a particular thing known as noise. It is a type of unwanted signal which can not be determined with respect to time. Now, whenever we are representing certain signal, we are writing mathematical expression and then we are representing on basic graphical representation. In basic graphical representation, this is the origin, this is the x-axis, and this is the y-axis. So, suppose in x-axis, if we will put time, and if on y-axis for deterministic signal, which is dependent on time, because it can be measured with respect to time. So in y-axis we can put over here x of t, because whatever be the value on y-axis we will get, that is dependent on x. On x we have plotted time, so it is x of t. Clear? So now we will see how a particular signal is deterministic. Suppose a signal is in this way. It is a deterministic signal. You can see over here, at particular instant of time, if I will take the instant of time like this, of course, or any other minute scale, any other scale smaller than that, then you can see over here how the signal is changing itself at every particular time period. Now, depending on this deterministic, there will be another two types of signal. One is continuous, another one is discrete. Continuous type of signal, discrete type of signal. Now, what is a continuous time of signal? So, you can say, first let me draw the representation of continuous time. just see over here on the board, without taking off this marker pen from the whiteboard, I am drawing in at one chance this signal. It will start from this point, it is ending at this point. Clear? That means at a single chance I am drawing this. This is a continuous type of thing. If I want, I can draw enormous type of this such waveforms. So this is a continuous type of stream we are getting. This is a continuous signal. Then what is a discrete signal? Of course, the continuous type of signal, whatever we will get, that is with respect to time. Similarly, in this side also. So you can see over here, these are particular time instants. All these are particular time instants. All these. Time instance. At any particular time, if I will get one distinct value of signal, that means at that particular time, only one particular value of the signal I will get. And you can see over here, every particular value is differing from one another. For this upcycle, again, whenever you will come over here, it will be similar. Just see. Like that. So, you can say that discrete type of signal will be obtained when we will get a particular signal value at a particular time period. That particular signal value is known as sample, and instead of t we will write small n over here, and instead of x of t we will write x of n over here. Clear? So n is what? N is nothing but number of samples. So we are getting for continuous, we are getting for discrete. Now let's move forward. So first, from signal we are getting deterministic, non-deterministic, further continuous and discrete. Now if I will move forward again, then what I will get? Then of course I will get another two types. One is periodic, another one is aperiodic. What are these two? A particular type of signal, if it will repeat itself after a certain interval of time, then that will be a periodic one. You can see over here, this signal is repeating itself after a certain interval of time. So this certain interval of time, whatever we are getting over here, this certain interval, if I will represent it like this, then this certain interval is known as fundamental time period. We can mark this as T naught or T here. So this is what? This is a periodic signal, For a periodic signal, this is the fundamental time period. Now then, what will be for aperiodic? Aperiodic is a thing if, suppose, this type of signal is there. Like this, or rather, suppose from here it will start, from here it is ending. Now suppose it is coming like this, again like this, again going like this. So this, you can see, this is an aperiodic signal. If I will put x of t versus t over here, you can see this is the time period where this is completing itself. And in the next time period, it is not like that, not similar to this. So this is an aperiodic signal. That means the waveform is not repeating itself. Now coming to the classification of periodic and aperiodic. This periodic signal, whatever I told you just now, this is also continuous as well as discrete. You can see this signal, this is a periodic continuous signal. If I will draw it like this, then of course I am getting the value n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4, n equal to 5, n equal to 6, n equal to 7, here n equal to 0, like this. So this is what? This is discrete time periodic signal. Clear? Because after this time period, again, if from this continuous I will draw it like this, this, just see, again it will repeat itself. Again it is repeating itself. That means what? This is a discrete time periodic signal. Is it clear? So continuous periodic you are seeing over here, discrete periodic also you have seen on the board. Now of course there is a chance when I can tell you that there will be discrete aperiodic also. Like continuous periodic, there will be discrete, like continuous periodic and continuous aperiodic, there will be discrete periodic, just now you have seen over here, there will be discrete aperiodic also. Clear? So whenever I am telling you about continuous signal, of course fundamental time period will be there. Whenever I am telling about discrete, this is continuous period, discrete periodic, of course there will be sampling period. That means that will be the total time after which it will repeat itself. So it will be a sampling period from here to here. This is the sampling period, from here to here, this is another, from here to here, this is another. So it is like that only. That means it will repeat itself after a certain time. That is the sampling period. So here the value is n, here the value is n, xn versus n. So So now, after this, we will come to further clarifications. And what are those clarifications? Now we can come to like this. That means now we can go for even and odd signals. So what is an even signal? It can be represented like this. What is an odd signal? Clear? Now, how I will represent this thing? You can see over here, I can come to the mathematical expression of periodic also. You can see over here, for even signal, we are getting the same value. That means magnitude will be same. Here magnitude will be same. But here there will be an inversion in the magnitude because of this negative sign. Because of this negative sign. Now how I will write if it is an even signal in continuous type? It may be like this. That means you can see over here both the signals are similar in nature, or in discrete type like this. So you can do it like this also. Is it okay? So you can see over here the exact replica. N equal to 1. Sorry, this will be N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1 and minus 1, same value. 2 and minus 2, same value. 3 and minus 3, same value. 4 and minus 4, same value. 5 and minus 5, same value. That means this is an even signal. But if I will tell you about the odd signal, suppose this is n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n equal to 3, n equal to 4. Then at n equal to minus 1, you will get this value. At n equal to 2, you will get this value. At n equal to minus 2, n equal to minus 3, you will get this value. And at n equal to minus 4, you will get this value. So n equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Clear? So it will be just like this. Is it okay? So this will be an odd signal. Now, this is the representation of even and odd signal. Now I am coming to the next one. How we can represent a periodic signal? This is the representation. After this fundamental time period, this signal will repeat itself, and this time can we go from minus infinity to infinity, whereas this will go from 0 to infinity, the fundamental time period. Is it okay? So this is the representation for even and odd signal. Now there are some basic signals which are known as singularity functions. Some basic signals are there also. Which are known as singularity functions. What are they? Impulse, step, ramp. Clear? One is impulse signal, one is step signal, one is ramp signal. What is the representation of impulse signal? T or M, XT or XN, T equal to 0 or N equal to 0. So this is the representation. This is the representation of impulse signal. Clear? That means you can see over here, if I will write it like this, that XT or xn equal to 0 elsewhere and equal to 1 at t equal to 0 or n equal to 0. This impulse function is also known as delta function, because it can be represented by delta of t or delta of n. This is one basic signal. Now we can go for another basic signal, which is nothing but step signal. How we can write about step signal? Xt or x of n, here t or n. Clear? Now how we can write this thing? In this case, we can write it like this. Suppose we have to write unit step. So this is the value 1 at n equal to 1, because this is n equal to 0, or say t equal to 0, we are getting this like, at n equal to 2, we are getting like this, at n equal to 3, we are getting like this. So like this you are getting. This is the representation for unit step. That means here you will get a step function whose value is always 1 at any particular instant of time or throughout. Now, how I will get that thing? If I will integrate this thing, suppose this value I will integrate, that means add over here, so that again this value I will get. This value again I will integrate over here, again another value will come. So by integration, this is the pictorial representation or interpretation. By this, from this impulse function, you will get unit step function. Clear? So now if I will come to ramp, the representation of ramp is like this. Here xt or xn, here t or n. Here we can write it like this, x of t equal to alpha t, where alpha is the slope. Is it okay? How to find the value of alpha? Alpha, you are knowing this thing, that means the distance over here and over here, the ratio of them will give you the slope of the signal. Okay. So, you can say that in this case, the value of xt for unit step, it can be represented as u of t equal to 1 at t, just see the value, at t greater than equal to 0, less than infinity, 0 elsewhere. That means I am not doing for the negative side, no, if I will go for the positive side. Similarly, for this, I am doing it for at t greater than equal to 0, less than equal to infinity. Clear? So, in this way, we will get step, ramp and impulse signal. Now, if I will integrate them, suppose if I will get over here step signal like this, which is gradually increasing, and if I will join their tip, then I will get a ramp signal like this. So by integration of this, by step, we will get ramp. This is the pictorial representation. So if you cannot do the mathematical interpretation, then you can do the pictorial representation, and by that, from impulse you can get step, and from step you can get ramp. Okay. Now suppose two periodic signals are given. Will their summation be a periodic one? Need not be so. Why that? Because suppose one periodic signal is x1 of t, another periodic signal is x2 of t. If I add both of them, suppose I am getting over here x3 of t. If, how this x3 of t is a periodic one? We have to find out the fundamental time period of this. We have to find out the fundamental time period of this. We have to find out the ratio for both of them and see if that is rational. If the ratio is rational, of course this is a periodic signal. If that ratio is not rational, that will be a periodic signal. Let me give you an example. Suppose the deterministic signal, we can write it like this, x of t is equal to alpha t, which is a representation of ramp signal, or we can write it like this, a sine omega t, just see over here, omega t by t minus phi. Is it okay? Or let us write it like this. like this. What is this? If I will represent this, how I will get x of t this value, this is the value that is equal with a, this is repeating itself, that means this is the fundamental time period, t is on x axis, and as because this is the angular movement, so we can express in terms of gradient. This is the phase shift. How we can go for phase shift? Instead of starting from the origin, if the signal will start from here, then it will go like this. If it will start from here, then it will go like this, like that. Here. So this is the phase shift. Phase shift can be represented by gradient. A is what? The maximum value of magnitude, which is nothing but an amplitude. Now just see over here. If I want to find out a signal which is a periodic one, let me give you an example. Suppose x of t equal to 25 pi t. Now see, if this thing is representable with that one, a sine 2 pi t by t naught minus pi, this is analogous with this one. This is the inside feature. The value of A, forget about this thing. Sine, forget about this thing. Phi, forget about this thing. Come to this thing. Okay? Or you can write it like this. Sine of. Here. So I am going for this one. Now just see whether this is how we can find out the fundamental time period. So just equate this thing, 25 pi t equal to 2 pi t divided by t naught. From here what I will get, pi t as this thing not equal to 0. So t naught will be 2 upon 25. Point, so 20 will come. Point 08, a rational value. So this is a rational waveform. That means a periodic waveform. Suppose I am giving you two examples, x1 of t equal to sine of root 2 pi t and x2 of t sine of 4 pi t. So find out t naught 1. Find out t naught 1. So from here what you will get? From here this you will get like this, 2 upon root 2, which is nothing but root 2, 1.414. Rational value it will not repeat itself. Irrational value it will repeat itself. Here what we will get, 2, ultimately 2 divided by 4, that means half, 0.5. Add both of them, you will get 1.914. After this point, whatever decimal value, they are not repeating itself. So what you can say? You can say that, sorry, if we will find out the ratio of both of them, 1.414 divided by that of 0.5. Now do this and find out if the ratio is a rational one or irrational one. If the ratio is a rational one, of course the summation will give you a periodic waveform. If the ratio is an irrational one, the summation will not give you a periodic waveform. So This is the representation by which you can find out whether the summation signal or whether the sum signal is periodic or aperiodic one. Now come to this thing. Causal and non-causal. Causal means it is a type of thing, or actually it is being attributed to a system. Causal is a type of thing which is dependable on past and present values of input. That means the output will be dependable on them. Where a non-causal is a system which is dependable on present and future values of input. Here. So in this way you can find out which one is causal, which one is non-causal. Suppose if I will write like this, y equal to x of n. From here you cannot find out. It is depending on present value, but whether it is causal or non-causal, it cannot be found out. But if you will write it like this, it is depending on past and present, so it is a causal. If you will write like this, it is a non-causal because it is depending on future value. After this, there will be two more signals which are known as power and energy signals. In the next class, we will go for power and energy signals. We will go for more interpretation for basic function, singularity function, differentiation, all types of derivations, etc. Thank you very much.